Hi everybody, this is Noelle from Petitti Garden Centers, and I'm so happy to be here at Casa Verde, our greenhouse facility. And we're gonna talk to you today about one of my favorite plants, indoor house plants, the philodendron family. We're gonna lump in the Monstera because they're very close cousins, but we're gonna talk about philodendrons. And they are one of the easiest plants to take care of. For all of you black thumbs, brown thumbs, everybody in between out there, this is a great plant to grow and at least try. Get your feet wet with the philodendron and then go from there. Not only are they easy to grow, but they are also one of the best air purifiers that you can place in your home. So there's lots of benefits to having these plants around. To start out with light. They really do not need direct sunlight coming in from the windows. And in Northeast Ohio in the winter, we really don't get a lot of days of really, really bright sun coming in through. So they are great. Medium indirect light is what they prefer. They can go a little bit brighter indirect. They can go a little bit lower indirect. And what they do like when we're talking about medium is it could be a northern window. It could be maybe 6 to 8 feet away from a bright window, so eastern, western, or southern exposure. And kind of in the middle of a bright room, they would do just fine in that area. They'd also work in 12 to 14 hours of artificial lighting. So hey, in an office, if you don't have any light or windows around you, great, they'll work out just fine for you there too. As far as temperatures are concerned, they like our same household temperature. So really anywhere between, let's say the 60 degree all the way up to the 80 degree mark, yeah, they'll do great, okay? The other thing about them that's really easy care is their watering. They really like to be on the drier side of watering. Don't get me wrong, when you do water them, you wanna go ahead and thoroughly moisten the soil in their pot, let the soil run out, and then do it one more time and then put it back in its spot. Now, what you're waiting for is for that soil to slowly dry out and for this philodendron to show you like a slight weeping. Like you can tell that it's just starting to get dry. So when you see that slight wilting occur, that's when you wanna go ahead and rewater. So go ahead and let them go slightly dry before you do that. The other thing that's really easy about them is that they do like humidity in the air. And believe me, in the wintertime, we can all benefit from some humidity. So go ahead and spray mist them. It's always good to water and spray mist in the morning if you can. Spray mist them or place them on a humidity tray, which is just a shallow tray of pebbles. Go ahead and fill that tray with water up to the top of the pebbles, and then place your pots of philodendron around on that tray. That works really, really well for them. Fertilizer. In the winter months, you really don't need to feed them with anything. We just like to feed the philodendron during the growing season. So let's say April through September, really a good time to feed. And they don't need any specific fertilizer, just a high nitrogen fertilizer or a balanced fertilizer. So if you see like a 20-20-20 on a package, that would work. So for example, a Miracle-Gro, or I also have Ospoma Organic Indoor. This type of fertilizer is concentrated. You mix it with water, follow the package directions, but it's gonna tell you you're gonna do one application once a month during the growing season. So really, really easy to take care of. If you're an Osmocote fan, usually 1 to 2 applications takes care of the entire year for the philodendron. So just be aware of that. As far as repotting goes, these guys actually, some are faster than others, but you'll notice when their root system starts to really come up in the pot and they start to appear at the surface of the soil. I have a philodendron right here. This is Xanadu. And Xanadu, as I'm looking at this pot, I can see the fibrous roots coming up in the soil. And as soon as I pull this plant out, you'll be able to tell there's quite a bit of root growth here. This plant needs to be repotted usually late winter, early spring, pretty standard time when we do repot a lot of house plants. And at that time, what I would do is I would remove some of these larger roots down at the bottom. I'd score the root ball, and I've done this before when we did a video on repotting a peace lily. And then I would put this in the next size pot up. So currently it's in a 6-inch pot. I would probably move it to 7 or 8-inch pot. Use new fresh potting soil. So make sure you have a good draining potting soil, sterile potting soil for inside the house. And then I'd go ahead and repot. Easy, very, very easy to do with these plants. Water well after you're done repotting, you're ready to go. One other thing that I really appreciate with philodendron is they're very easy to start from cuttings. So you could literally take a leaf, okay, go down to the base of the leaf and clip it or peel it off. And the next thing you know, you could actually put this in a small vase of water and it would start rooting for you. Once it starts rooting, you can go ahead and repot in moist potting soil. Let it grow, you know, nearby some of the other philodendron plants that you have, and you're ready to go to propagate. Or you could pop it right next to the parent plant in that pot. Just make sure that it's moist soil that it's in. So that's why we tend to plant that in a smaller pot where you can keep the soil a little bit more moist, okay? So different varieties of philodendron. There's lots. I have everything from the Large Leaf Salome. I love this one. It's got that beautiful sort of ruffled lobe on it. These plants can get enormous, 6 foot, 8 foot tall, okay? I have the Monstera. This is your classic Monstera. Again, a cousin of the philodendron, but the care is it's just the same, very same. So the Monstera here is what we also call a split leaf philodendron, if you ever hear that. Here I have some trailing philodendron. The one with the bronze leaf is called Philodendron Micans. It's a really pretty trailer. This is your heart-shaped or heart-leaf philodendron. These make great hanging baskets. You can put them up on shelves, let their tendrils trail down, or they will also grow up a support. So just be aware that they can grow up or trail down. I also have some beautiful, colorful philodendron. This is Lemon Lime. And right next to me is a beautiful Imperial Red. And you see that new leaf coming out has that maroon reddish color. Beautiful. These philodendron are a little bit more, I would say, mounded, rounded form. They don't tend to trail or grow up as quickly as some of the others, but still just as beautiful out there. These are actually all the Monstera types. So this is Ginny. And Ginny is just kind of like a smaller split leaf philodendron, just a small version of this guy, right? So this is a Monstera, Ginny. And then this one is the immature form of this guy, okay? So this is your true Monstera, but when they're small, they have that heart leaf shape. So I think that's why people get the heart leaf philodendron and the Monstera kind of mixed. And again, they're very similar, but they are a different species. This is a Monstera as well, but this is called the Swiss cheese Monstera. And you see all of the holes through those leaves. You can also tell this one starts kind of upright growing, but then look at the branches coming out on this. So it can start trailing. You can start training it up a trellis and it will do very well. And I can see also some air roots forming here. So you could literally cut below the air roots and go ahead and start rooting this one also in a vase, okay? So a lot about the philodendron family. They're easy care plants. Enjoy.